Hey, Jordan Adler here from Las Vegas. I am an Eagle distributor in SendOutCards. Been with SendOutCards now for about 13 years, and also the author of the Amazon bestseller, Beach Money. And what I want to do right now is spend a few minutes and teach you how to get started in your new SendOutCards business. Very simple. There's really only two things that I'm going to suggest that you do over the next 2 weeks. And just to keep it very simple, if you'll do these two things, number one, you're going to be well on your way to launching your business. You'll be really, really excited about your business and you'll be well trained. So here's what I'm going to suggest you do. And this is what I teach every single new distributor to do when they get started in the business. Number one, I want you to send out 3 cards a day, all right? But not any cards. I want you to send out a specific card. On your Facebook wall, you'll notice that people on Facebook, they post things that are exciting and interesting and fun for them. It's the best things in their lives they put on Facebook. They put their new puppy on Facebook. When they have a new grandbaby, they put that on Facebook. When they get married, they put that on Facebook. When they take their family to Disneyland, they put that on Facebook. And so you want to take those pictures and using the app on your phone, you want to save the picture to your phone and then put it on the front of a card. And then in the card, no sales pitch. Don't say anything about trying to send out cards to them or anything else. That's all you're going to do is celebrate them. So somewhere in the card, you need to say something like, I appreciate you. Now, if you want to add more to it, put their name in there, of course, and then sign your name. If you want to say more than that, that's up to you. But at least I appreciate you. And you can change the text and make it bigger. But I want you to send that to 3 people a day for the next 2 weeks and keep track. That's it. 3 people a day. Now, if you want to do more than that, you can, but you want to keep track of 3 a day. Now, big question comes up. Where do I find addresses? Because I don't have people's addresses. Very simple. So all you do is post in their inbox, private message, or text them a very specific phrase. And you want to write this down word for word. I'm updating my contact manager and I'd love to get your mailing address. I'm updating my contact manager, and I'd love to get your mailing address. Now, I trained someone not that long ago, and after a few days, I texted her, and I asked her, how's it going in sending your cards out? And she said, well, I haven't been sending them. And I got a little direct with her because, you know, she really wants to do this, and I really didn't ask her to do much. I just said, you know, this is your business. You're in SendOutCards as a business, and if you're not sending cards out, then why are you even in the business? And I got a little, you know, direct with her, and she texted me and she said, nobody's giving me their mailing address. And I said, text me exactly what you're texting them. And she sent me this. She said, I'm updating my contact manager and I'd love to get your information. And they didn't send her their address. That's not what I asked her to text them. I'm updating my contact manager and I'd love to get your mailing address. So that's exactly what you have to put in the private message or in the text message. I'm updating my contact manager and I'd love to get your mailing address. By the way, when I first got started in the business, I wasn't texting yet, but I did email that to a whole bunch of people. And you don't want to spam it out to everybody, just one person at a time. Send that out. You'll get their mailing address. Put a picture on the front of a card from Facebook, something that they're celebrating, or you know, it could be that they recently lost their grandma. And they put that on Facebook. You could send them a sympathy card, or somebody celebrating a birthday. You could send them a late birthday card because you saw it on Facebook, whatever. But you want to grab pictures from Facebook, put it on the front of a card. And a lot of people don't know this, but that card will fit perfectly in a 5x7 picture frame. And a lot of people will display those in their homes. Those cards are so important. So that's the first thing. First thing is send out 3 cards a day, personal cards a day, no sales pitch, no sales message, and do that for 2 weeks. Now, what's going to happen? After 2 weeks, you're going to have 42 people minimum in your contact manager, right? 42, and you're going to have sent out 42 cards. And what you're going to find is some of those people will be so happy and excited that you sent them the card because it's so unusual. They're going to take that, and they're going to take a picture of it, and they're going to put it on Facebook for all their friends to see. Really cool. And some of them are probably going to ask you, how you did it, and you'll then be able to contact your upline and then do a presentation for them. Okay, that's the first thing. The second thing you're going to do is go to www.thecoolbuzz.com. It's www.thecoolbuzz.com. That's where we host all the replays of the Monday night training call. So you go to www.thecoolbuzz.com, click on replays, and it start at the top. And what you're going to do is listen to one of those a day. So the whole commitment, daily commitment, is going to be somewhere between 45 minutes and an hour. So you want to go to thecoolbuzz.com, click on replays, start at the top, and listen to one a day. So if your sponsor texts you or calls you after your fifth day and says, how's it going getting started? You can tell them that you've sent out your three cards and you've listened to your conference call. I just recently got a new distributor restarted. Her name's Taylor Rivera. And I texted her on her fifth day, and she told me she's right on track. And then one day she told me she missed a day, which is fine, but she made it up the next day. So for your first 14 days in the business, very simple. Three cards a day with a picture from Facebook, something in the card that says, I appreciate you, and listen to one conference call a day. At the end of the 2 weeks, you are going to be so flippin' excited about your Send Out Cards business. You're going to have all kinds of ideas. You're going to be calling your upline because you're going to want them to help you get your business going and show it to some people. And also, you're going to have your contact manager starting to get full. You'll be in the habit of sending cards, and you'll be well on your way. Now, after the 2 weeks, what's going to happen? Your upline's going to get with you, and they're going to want to sit down with you either over the phone on a Zoom call or in person, and they're going to go over 13 items that they're going to text you. And those 13 items actually are on this Facebook group. If you scroll down a little bit, you'll see them. These are the 13 steps to getting started. But we don't want to get too much into these steps until after your first 2 weeks, where you've done the two things that we talked about every day. So the 13 steps are things like setting up your handwriting font and your signatures, and you know, understanding how to put together your custom back and all those kinds of things. So and getting into the Facebook group, all that. In the beginning, I just really want you to do those two basic things for 2 weeks. And you, after those that 2 week training period, you are going to be so dialed in and so ready to build your business, and so well trained that there's nothing that's going to stop you. So that's what we're going to do. And if you have any questions, just post them in the group and we'll get your questions answered. So thanks for listening. Talk to you soon.